Donald Trump has said the U.S. is considering stopping all trade with any country that does business with North Korea. His announcement in a tweet could be aimed primarily at China, with East Pyongyang only majorly and a key trading partner. Tension between the U.S. and North Korea have increased after Pyongyang said it had tested a hydrogen bomb, its sixth and most powerful nuclear detonation to date. The U.S. president has been meeting his military chief, and when asked by reporter earlier if America would attack North Korea, he replied, "We'll see." His defense secretary, General James Mattis, said any threat to the U.S. if territory or it only by Pyongyang would be met with a massive military response. He said America was not looking to the total annihilation of the North, but we have many options to do so. Writing on Twitter, Mr. Trump has warned that appeasing the North will not work, adding they only understand one thing, said the regime word and action continue to be very hostile and dangerous to the United States. He also denounced the secretive country as a rogue nation which has become a great threat and embarrassment to China, which is trying to help but with little success. Nuclear test was diplomatic weapon to divide U.S. and China, would Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin said he would compile a new Songshan package, potentially to cut off all trade with North Korea. The UN Security Council is set to discuss the crisis on Monday. South Korea has called for the strongest possible response, including new UN Songshan to completely isolate its northern neighbor. So National Security Advisor Chung Yu-yong said they had been talk with Washington about deploying U.S. strategic military assets to the Korean Peninsula. So Defense Ministry said the U.S. and South Korean military chief have spoken on the telephone and agreed the test was a provocation that cannot be overlooked. The chairman of the Joint Chief of Staff, General Jong Kyong-doo and General Joseph Dunford, agreed to prepare a South Korea's military counteraction and to put it into action at the earliest date. China said it strongly condemned the detonation. President Xi Jinping and Russian leader Vladimir Putin have agreed to appropriately deal with the latest test and stick to the goal of denuclearization on the Korean Peninsula. And Japan Foreign Minister Taro Kono described the new explosion as extremely unforgivable. The device, which is thought to have been about 5 times larger than the bomb drop on the Japanese city of Nagasaki in World War II, caused a man-made earthquake. Key step in North Korea's nuclear and ballistic missile ambition, Pyongyang said via state media that it had detonated a hydrogen bomb with perfect success. It claimed the device could be mounted on its newly developed intercontinental ballistic missile, which experts have said are capable of reaching the U.S. mainland. There has been no independent confirmation the detonation was a hydrogen bomb rather than a less powerful atomic weapon of the kind Pyongyang has tested in the past. Prime Minister Theresa May said the reckless nuclear test posed an unacceptable further threat to the international community. Foreign Secretary Boris Johnson said if North Korea managed to fit a hydrogen bomb to a successful missile, it would unquestionably present a new order of threat. Concerning the way ahead, Mr. Johnson said that none of the military options are good, but on Songshan, he pointed out that China is responsible for 90% of North Korea's threat, adding that Kim Jong-un nation has only 6 months of oil supply left. He said Brighton Message to Beijing was within thermoscope for you the Chinese to put economic pressure on the North Korean.